My name is Regina. Welcome to the Women and Leadership Archives YouTube channel. For me, December always invokes memories of farewells and hugs exchanged at the end of a semester and the prospect of family time. What are some of your memories of December? Some Christmas memories Mundelein students had involved a woolly blanket, millions of tiny lights, the star at the top of the Christmas tree, a shivering Santa Claus on Michigan Avenue, and of course, the infinite beauty of Christmas time. Christmas at Mundelein certainly sounded beautiful and rather busy. Students were involved in charity projects such as gathering dolls to distribute to children. Christmas cantatas were also another feature at Mundelein this period, with students in charge of writing and performing in them. Students of different cultural backgrounds would also gather to swap stories of their family's Christmas time traditions. Of all this, perhaps the earliest and most significant Mundelein Christmas tradition was that of the candlelighting ceremony, or the candlelight and carol procession. It consisted of lighting candles in the windows of Mundelein College to form a nine-story cross, symbolizing the light of the world. Since the windows faced Sheridan Road, the lights were visible to commuters passing by. But the ceremony did not always look this way. In the grand tradition of, well, traditions, the candlelighting ceremony underwent several changes over the decades, reflecting both societal and institutional changes. When the tradition first began in 1930, there was no cross of light in the windows of the skyscraper building. Instead, a single row of candles was lit on each floor. The first cross of candlelight took place in 1931. Singing carols from various countries, student club officers made their way through the corridors and placed their candles in the windows. After this, selected students, typically the senior class president and the president of the Mundelein Student Council, would hang wreaths at the main entrance of Mundelein College to signify the start of the holidays. In 1936, the first college candle began a new ceremony, which took place on the day before the cross was lit. Students lit their candles from the chapel sanctuary lamp, and all candles were extinguished as the college candle was lit, symbolizing the unity of spirit of the students. During the Second World War, candlelighting was dedicated to the service personnel. Programs bore the names of active and deceased service personnel acquainted with Mundelein students and faculty. The cross of candlelight was discontinued in 1959, apparently due to the construction of the Scholasticate and other high-rise apartments on Sheridan Road, which presumably obstructed the view of the cross. In 1965, following the changes ushered in by the Second Vatican Council, Hanukkah commemorations were also added to the candlelighting ceremony. In 1972, the ceremony was moved to McCormick Lounge in Coffee Hall, Mundelein's main dormitory building. As suggested by this picture here, the ceremony has grown more casual, with students dressed in pajama robes and fluffy slippers. After the merger with Loyola was announced in 1991, candlelighting ceremonies involving students from both schools were held until 1993. Even though the cross of candlelight is no longer visible in the windows of the skyscraper building, there is a new iconic sight to greet commuters passing by Sheridan Road around Christmas time. Since the 2000s, the three wise men have trekked westward from Lake Michigan to the Nativity in front of the skyscraper building. The next time you pass Sheridan Road in early December, keep your eyes peeled. We hope you have enjoyed learning about this beautiful tradition at Mundelein College. Remember to subscribe to get the latest content. See you next time!